Good morning to you both. Diane, I want to get your initial reaction to the report we saw this morning, as well as the fact that we are seeing upward revisions for the last couple of months as well, and how it speaks to the strength, maybe stronger than previously expected strength of the labor market here.
Yeah, it's terrific. And it does actually put the Fed into taper mode. They need to see August, which is, of course, the Delta month. That said, that where the Delta variant has had the worst spread is areas where we have seen less job search than areas that didn't have as much that had higher vaccine rates. But that is going to be the big determinant. Even the most dovish on the Fed, Governor Weller, has already argued that these kinds of job gains, 2 months of them in July and August, would be enough to justify the tapering talk for September announcement. And I think that's what we're going to be focused on. This opens the door to that. There is a couple things that are important in the nuances of the data. Yes, we did see a slight tick up in the participation rate. We saw some drawdown in those long-term unemployed, still elevated, but that was good news because people are stepping up and showing up to be hired. But on the other side of it, the places where we saw participation rate actually recede a bit and still on the sidelines were blacks and black and Hispanic women. Those were the hardest hit workers early on, the most marginalized. And this is what Chairman Powell has been talking about, needing to have a really hot economy to bring those workers who are the most marginalized out there back into the fold.
David, want to get your thoughts on what this means for the markets here, and not just equities, but as Carl mentioned before, the fact that we're seeing the yield on the 10-year creep higher too.
Yes, and I mean, they're still extraordinarily low. I mean, if you look at the 10-year TIPS market going into this, we were at negative 1.1% in real terms. So we've got very, very low bond yields. And frankly, they're offside here. The economy is recovering. Yes, I get it that the virus is mutating. But you know what? The economy is mutating. It's adapting also. We're finding ways of growing back, recovering through this pandemic. I expect that the August numbers will be more challenging because of Delta, but then Delta will diminish somewhat. And I think this reopening is keeping going. And we're growing at, somewhere north of 5-6% in real GDP terms. We're growing about three times as fast as the long-term trend growth rate of the U.S. economy. So we're barreling towards full employment here. And we really need to get to a more normal place in terms of monetary policy. So for markets, it's positive for equities. But I think it is very much a rotation from growth to value. I think it's a time when you've got to really look at valuations, because interest rates won't be this low for that much longer.